to this episode of NTB Dialogues, a thought-provoking and insightful series of interviews with leaders who are there helping to accelerate the fight against tuberculosis, which 193 countries of the world have promised to end by 2030. Today we are very fortunate to have with us Dr. Ramesh Kumar Kharel from Nepal, who is director of SARC Tuberculosis and HIV AIDS Center. SARC is South Asia Association of Regional Cooperation, comprising 8 countries. Welcome, Dr. Kharel. Could you share with us your center's role in TB care and control in these 8 countries? You are looking, overseeing the operations in 8 countries. Right.
Thank you very much. Yes, SARC and STAC. STAC is stand for the TB and HIV Center, looking after the 8 countries: Nepal, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Maldives, Pakistan, Sri Lanka. All. So the challenge and opportunity is there always, but we have to deal with the major challenges, which is our institution is comprised of this 8 country. The center is run by the commitment of financial commitment, policy commitment from the member states. So as we know, TB is one of the big public health issue globally than any other disease, what we understand, because of its transmission, oral transmission, aerosol transmission, than any other disease. So our center is looking after the guidance for all 8 countries, making policy, making strategy, how to eliminate TB epidemic from the 8 member state country. As we know that India has taken this enthusiastic opportunity of SDG, that the elimination of this TB epidemic from India to 2025. So other country also, they have committed, some country 27, some country 20, 30. So overall, our center worked with this 8 member state, especially with all major stakeholder, with the Ministry of Health, under which National TB program as well as HIV AIDS program. Because we know that TB and HIV co-infection is very related. So we make the policy, we make the implementation of program monitoring. Also, we also evaluate the midterm review of the program of TB in all member states also. So that is also very important, what is going on. Based on the result, we have to have a policy built up, and that will be implemented. As well, as we said that we 8 country, the major issue is, again, we talk about the TB, latent TB. Not only latent TB, even the cross-border issue between India-Nepal, India-Bhutan, Pakistan-Afghanistan. So we also run multicentric study, researches going on. So I think in coming days, I have just joined this position 3 or 4 months back, and I think it is not very long period, but I see maybe some white hairs here, but I am still feel myself 2025 in terms of community achievement, in terms of welfare of the client of TB, latent TB, multi-drug resistance TB, XDR TB, because we know, my experience and my feeling, how we can help the client community, their engagement to remedy of epidemics of TB in coming days. I think hope in future I'll try my best to optimally coordination, cooperation in real meaning to reduce TB and always HIV morbidity and mortality and commitment of the member states for SDG goal 2.
Can you share some of the challenges of your own country, particularly in relation to latent TB infection, and what is being done to empty that pool of people so that they do not convert into active tuberculosis?
So we are now initiated latent TB among the health worker provider. The one research is going on. Another national TB program they are doing, I think it is in the final stage, the TB prevalence, which will be very helpful in coming days. That is from the national TB program. And after this research, we also do in other member state. So our physical year, new year, starts from January for 2020. Soon we have a governing board meeting where I can put agendas which is related with latent TB and all. So regarding latent TB, even in Nepal, the situation is the same, because we face a lot of problem. We started 1985, 90s, those days when we started dots per center, then dots plus. Now we are in strategically elimination of TB epidemiology from the country, from the all member states. That's why we are talking about latent TB. Most of the latent TB that will convert it in the active TB. So it is very important us to engage in latent TB as well, other TB.
So as currently, is there any facility for testing for latent TB, or any high-risk groups, are they being tested and treated for latent TB? Because even the political declaration of UNHLM on TB, there are later on some targets have been set for countries to up to 2022 to put so many people on preventive therapy to diagnose and put them on preventive treatment. So
now we say we have initiated recently. And now we have a focus on latent TB. But debate is still going on everywhere. Should we treat or not? We have to priority for this or not? So I think, in my personal view, as a SARC leader of STAG, I think it is mandatory that we have to focus in latent TB, without which we cannot elimination a TB epidemic in time, in coming days. I think this is one of the most issue-centered thing which every country has to initiate. Though I am not a scientist, but I feel as a medical student, as well as the middle-level manager, I can say that without this we cannot say by TB to eliminate epidemiologists. It is related with the latent TB too.
So are there any tests which are available, and any treatment which is being given has started in Nepal or no?
I think individually they are doing. Okay. Because when we started, very few centers, microscopic center, it was very difficult even to bring their sputum from the very remote mountain place to the district level or health facility. You pay some incentive. So now we have using Gen Expert, and many debate are there, bacteriological, then culture. So many things related with this, which I also did a study in differentiation yesterday. I think in individual level, in the hospital, they are doing, especially national TB program is looking after that. and we are very close with National TB program as well as a member state. Also, we are till now there is a OPD base. Now 50-bedded hospital is being built in National TB under National TB program. The hospital hope in coming days it will be taken as a granted for all these issues.
You have taken up your office recently. Any specific measures you have in your mind which you think you will promote just to hasten this fight and to at least win this fight against TB? Anything specific which you would propose?
So, I think in this center, just for 4 months I am here, and I think I am the earth director in the center. And our previous 7 directors, they have dreamed to make SARC stack as a supranational laboratory, and that is one of the major priority for me, because it was dreamed in 2009 and it is 2019. Thanks God we have started MU with India, so that we can make it in 5 years we are going to be functioning of this supranational lab. What it does mean, it will look after the all our regional national laboratory, monitoring their quality. I'm also dreaming as others director they did. In coming days it will be established, and which will be the major my priority in coming days to build a supranational laboratory.
What about tobacco control activities? Because tobacco has a direct link with TB, particularly smoking. So, also TB is linked to to other NCDs also, non-communicable diseases, and their prevention. So, how do you see to integrate or to deal with tobacco control as part of TB control?
I think tobacco really, even it is for normal human, is good not to have. Also, it affects the second hand, passive victims are there. So it must be one of the integrated part of National TB program, which will be really fruitful in coming days, because science has proven, research has proven that smoke that accelerated TB, which many death of the TB also related with this devastating tobacco, either chewing tobacco, even when we smoke it, of course it will be take a lot of death, which is preventable. Itself TB is preventable. Why not to prevent? Why should we die before the time? Why not to implement all globally, but still fighting are going on. Tobacco producing, factory, many things is there. But I think most of the country in our region, they have adopted the regulation. They have adopted the act, but still maybe I think we have also in Ministry of Health, they are taking consideration on this, and the packet 90% of the danger signs are going on, but still we are not getting as it was anticipated. But it's a hurdle, so every hurdle will be crushed together with understanding of community, people, leaders, bureaucrats, media, and the media role is a very, very high in this. And I think I'm very happy to be here, honored in this. This is my first time this conference, as I was manager of that. So it is my opportunity. Also, thank you very much for this. I am also the voting right on this. So member for last 20 years, our institution director is always a member for voting rights, which we did today also. Hope in future we can really make our region TV free in time, but it needs tremendous effort from each and every person and each and every level, which is very, very important.
Thank you, Dr. Ramesh Kumar Kharel. Friends, we were listening to Dr. Ramesh Kumar Kharel, who is director of SARC Tuberculosis and HIV AIDS Center. And he was speaking to us on site from the 50th Union World Conference on Lung Health being held in Hyderabad, India. Thank you very much. And this was the next this was the latest episode of our NTB Dialogue series. Thank you.
Thank you very much.